Turkey is making waves in global defense with the unveiling of its groundbreaking $200 billion investment in AI-powered fighter jets and combat drones. These advanced technologies showcase Turkey's ambition to redefine air combat and strengthen its military capabilities, positioning itself as a formidable force on the global stage. Turkey is prepared for war at any given time. The HÜRJET is a new generation light combat aircraft, an advanced jet trainer developed by Turkish Aerospace Industries. While primarily designed as a trainer aircraft, the HÜRJET is also intended for combat roles, including close air support, air policing, and counterinsurgency operations. The aircraft's design philosophy emphasizes versatility and adaptability, allowing it to serve multiple roles across various mission profiles. It features a modern airframe with advanced aerodynamics and a high-performance turbofan engine, providing excellent maneuverability and speed. The HÜRJET integrates several advanced technologies that could include AI components. These technologies enhance situational awareness and decision-making, providing pilots with real-time data and analytics to optimize mission outcomes. The HÜRJET is expected to play a key role in Turkey's Air Force, serving both as a trainer for future pilots and as a light combat aircraft capable of performing a range of missions. The Kalkan spy drone is a state-of-the-art surveillance and reconnaissance drone developed by Turkey. Designed for intelligence-gathering missions, the Kalkan drone represents a significant advancement in Turkey's unmanned aerial vehicle capabilities. Its primary role is to perform surveillance and reconnaissance missions over various terrains, providing real-time data to military commanders. The Kalkan is equipped with high-resolution cameras, infrared sensors, and advanced electronic warfare capabilities, allowing it to detect and track enemy movements from a significant distance. One of its standout features is its low observability, designed to reduce its radar cross-section and heat signature, making it highly stealthy and difficult to detect. In addition to its primary surveillance role, the Kalkan spy drone can be equipped with a variety of payloads to suit different mission profiles. The drone's endurance and range are optimized for long-duration missions, allowing it to remain airborne for extended periods, covering vast operational areas without needing frequent refueling or recharging. The KAAN is Turkey's first indigenous fifth-generation fighter jet, marking a significant milestone in the country's aerospace and defense industry. The KAAN is designed to incorporate advanced technologies that position it as a formidable asset in modern air warfare. Among its most notable features are its stealth capabilities, achieved through advanced design techniques that reduce its radar cross-section and improve its survivability in hostile environments. A key aspect of the KAAN fighter jet is its emphasis on artificial intelligence technologies. These include sensor fusion, which allows the aircraft to integrate data from multiple sensors to provide a comprehensive situational awareness to the pilot. Advanced data links enable seamless communication and data exchange with other aircraft and ground units, enhancing coordination and mission effectiveness. The potential integration of autonomous combat capabilities represents a significant step forward in AI development, enabling the jet to make real-time decisions in complex combat scenarios without human intervention. The T-129 ATAK is a versatile attack helicopter developed jointly by Turkish Aerospace Industries and Leonardo Helicopters. This twin-engine, multi-role helicopter is designed for both attack and reconnaissance missions, capable of operating in a variety of terrains and environmental conditions. The T-129 is equipped with advanced avionics, weapon systems, and mission equipment, making it highly effective in counter-terrorism operations and conventional warfare scenarios. It can perform a range of missions, from close air support and deep strike to armed reconnaissance and anti-tank warfare. Its advanced targeting systems, including a helmet-mounted display, provide pilots with enhanced situational awareness and precision strike capabilities, making it a formidable force multiplier on the battlefield. In addition to its combat capabilities, the T-129 features advanced electronic warfare systems designed to increase survivability in hostile environments. The Bayraktar Kızılelma is an advanced unmanned combat aerial vehicle developed by Baykar, a leading Turkish defense company. The Kızılelma is designed with a low radar cross-section to enhance its stealth capabilities, making it difficult to detect by enemy radar systems. It is equipped with a turbofan engine capable of achieving supersonic speeds, which provides both a tactical advantage in terms of speed and the ability to evade enemy air defenses. The drone is built to perform a wide range of missions, including air-to-air combat, air-to-ground strikes, electronic warfare, and ISR missions. Kızılelma is equipped with state-of-the-art avionics and sensors, including an active electronically scanned array radar, which provides superior target detection and tracking capabilities. The integration of artificial intelligence systems enables advanced autonomous flight operations, such as target acquisition, navigation, and combat engagement, without requiring constant input from human operators. One of the distinguishing features of the Kızılelma is its capability to operate from aircraft carriers and amphibious assault ships. This is a significant advantage for Turkey, allowing the UKAV to be deployed in various theaters of operation, including the Mediterranean and Aegean Seas, where Turkey has strategic interests. Turkey's Anka 3, an advanced jet-powered drone developed by Turkish Aerospace Industries, represents a significant step in Turkey's unmanned aerial vehicle, UAV, evolution. Anka 3 is a stealthy, unmanned combat aerial vehicle designed for high-end reconnaissance, combat, and intelligence-gathering missions. Its key features include a low observable design that enhances its stealth capabilities, making it ideal for operations in contested environments. Recent updates have focused on refining the drone's aerodynamic shape to minimize radar visibility, significantly improving its range, speed, and payload capabilities. The Anka 3 is expected to support a wide variety of missions, ranging from intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance to air-to-ground strikes and potentially electronic warfare operations. This advanced drone is also designed to carry a diverse range of munitions, giving it exceptional flexibility in different combat scenarios and making it a versatile asset on the battlefield. The Kargu 2 is a quadcopter drone built by the Turkish company STM. It uses machine learning algorithms embedded on the platform, enabling it to operate autonomously as well as manually. The Kargu 2 is designed as an anti-personnel weapon, capable of selecting and engaging human targets based on machine learning object classification. Although various ammunition options are available, the Kargu 2 detonates an explosive charge close to the target, minimizing collateral damage. Due to these characteristics, humanitarian concerns should focus on the drone's ability to distinguish legitimate military targets from protected civilians and direct its attacks accordingly. The technical difficulties of proportionality assessments when civilian collateral damage is expected are irrelevant, unless the Kargu 2 is deployed in heavily populated civilian areas. Weapons that cannot make this distinction or limit their attack effects are already prohibited under customary international law. Commanders and operators must do everything feasible to verify that targets are legitimate military objectives and cancel or suspend an attack if it becomes apparent that the target is not a military objective. The Bayraktar TB3 is an advanced UAV developed by the Turkish company Baykar, following the success of its predecessor, the Bayraktar TB2. With a folding wing design, the TB3 is tailored for naval operations, enabling it to launch from short runways or ship decks, enhancing Turkey's maritime capabilities. The TB3 features a wingspan of approximately 14 meters and a maximum takeoff weight of around 1,450 kilograms. The UAV is powered by a single turboprop engine, which allows it to achieve a maximum speed of 300 kilometers an hour. The TB3 is designed to carry a payload of up to 280 kilograms, which includes advanced sensors, electro-optical infrared cameras, synthetic aperture radar, and a variety of precision-guided munitions. The TB3 can operate at an altitude of up to 30,000 feet and has an endurance of more than 24 hours, making it suitable for long-duration missions. The UAV is capable of conducting a wide range of missions, including intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, and precision strikes against ground and sea targets. The TB3 incorporates advanced avionics, autonomous flight capabilities, and AI for improved navigation, targeting, and situational awareness. The UAV's deployment on the TCG Anadolu will enable Turkey to conduct UAV operations far from its mainland, providing strategic flexibility and extending its operational reach in the Mediterranean, Aegean, and Black Seas. Jackal is a small, light, and compact unmanned aerial vehicle designed and developed by British Flyby Technology, Turkish Fly Baulas Technology, and Maxwell Innovation. The Jackal drone, equipped with missiles capable of striking armored vehicles, is approaching its first order. Armed with martlet missiles, which have a warhead weight of 3 kilograms, it can effectively destroy APCs and IFVs. This offers an intriguing solution that could undermine the standard tactics of using attack helicopters. Combining a drone with man pads to counterattack helicopters appears to be an ideal countermeasure against the tactic of helicopters hiding behind terrain. However, with such an anti-aircraft drone, this tactic becomes ineffective. This type of weaponry potentially makes attack helicopters, which can engage targets in a non-line-of-sight mode, seem powerless. Taiwan is the first buyer, having ordered 160 of these UAVs. An agreement has been made between the British company Flyby Technology and Geosat Aerospace regarding the transfer of technology and the production of 160 UAVs as announced by the Taiwanese company. Thanks for watching, and make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and put notifications on to stay updated on everything related to AI and robotics.